to another episode of Strategic Minds Making Money Moves. We all want to go after that green. Today's episode, boy, I tell you, it's going to be really, really interesting. I am looking so forward to hearing from Selena Thompson. She is the owner of The Savvy Apprentice. So we're going to learn all about her business today, and we're going to see if we can solve a problem or two. Welcome.
Hello. I'm so happy to be here. How are you?
Well, I'm glad to have you. Would you share with our audience about The Savvy Apprentice?
I sure can. The Savvy Apprentice is a virtual assistant agency. So my business focuses on the administrative support, the customer support, and a lot of the, I'd say, the business operational side of things. I help minority business owners, specifically entrepreneurs and coaches, strategists, life coaches, career coaches. I help them basically with their CRM and administrative support. So I kind of work on the back end and do things. Things that most of them don't have time to do, such as scheduling, calendar management, sometimes emailing clients, invoices, things like that.
Okay, what's a CRM? Tell our audience what a CRM is.
A CRM is a customer relations management system. So a lot of those systems you can find in Google, like Zoho. We have Monday.com is really good, very popular. Asana. A lot of those programs out there are really helpful, but they're very time consuming. So a lot of my clients, they don't have the time to sit up there and figure that out and put all their clients into that database. And that's where I come in.
That's awesome. That's great. I know that a lot of us can always use a virtual assistant. Trying to be your own calendar management and phone calls and this and that. Like, whoa, wait a minute. I got to sail through. When am I going to find time to do all of this? So the service is very well needed. So that's good to hear about the opportunities that are out there. Why don't you share with the audience what your challenge is?
Well, a lot of my challenges right now, it's just been I have time management. So I am a single mother. I have two children of my own. I also have a 9-to-5. So I do a lot of things. It's very busy. So with that being said, it's a lot with the time management. And I'm also wanting to expand my business and focus a lot more on the customer support, especially with our Black business owners. I want to make sure I'm helping putting the word out that customer service should always be at the optimal level. So I want to focus on just getting bigger and expanding my vision.
Well, you know, that's interesting. And we all know that when we talk about expanding our vision and expanding the things that we want to do, that time management is always going to be a challenge. So let's kind of break this up into two components. Do you use a calendaring system today in terms of blocking your times and what you do?
Yes. So I have to be in the know with Gmail. Gmail is my favorite calendaring system right now. So I do use that. I do have so many alarms because I work out every day. So I'm up at 5 a.m. and probably going to sleep at midnight. So Gmail is my friend.
Okay. All right. So you do have a system to be able to talk about what's coming up and things like that.
Yeah.
Have you had the opportunity to sit down and look at your all the things that you do? And I call that a portfolio of time. Mm-hmm. And our portfolio of time is made up of all the components of things that require us. So how much of that portfolio is kid time? How much of kid's time? How much of that portfolio is me time? How much of that portfolio is my virtual assistant time? How much of that portfolio is a regular 8-to-5 job time? And how much of that portfolio goes to my business? And the reason it's important to look at that and to take a historical perspective is to build a vision of what you want it to be. If you look historically, you may find that the way you divide your time out is not what you were thinking. It wasn't as much as you thought it was. It wasn't in the right buckets. And then you can reprioritize. I now know how I spend my time. I now know what I'm doing. This is out of kilter with this. I really need to make some modifications in terms of what I'm doing. So I think it's really important to understand your portfolio of time. The second thing is that if you're talking about expanding in business, now you're talking about even more time,
right?
And so the opportunity has to come to play. Okay, if I'm going to expand my business and do things, and if I look at this portfolio of time and there's no time for it, something has to either be outsourced or I have to stop doing something. Right? Because you can't make any more minutes up than 24 hours in a day. Even though I wish I could find the one that could make it 36 hours some days, and then I want to make it 18 hours another day. But, you know, in terms of being able to do that, it's really important that we begin to look at that when we look at time management, because expanding of a business is going to take more time. You mentioned that that as you're thinking about this, that you also have, you know, other services that you want to do a concentration on. Mm-hmm. So I encourage you that once you first start looking at this time and where you want to go, is to really think about where that slice would come in and who am I taking away from? What am I taking away from? You know, it's, you've got your children you have to take care of that need to be provided. You got an 8 to 5. Those are kind of two stuck things, right? Mm-hmm. And then you don't want to give up time for yourself in terms of your workout time. So is it that I get up earlier? Is it that I go to, you know, as I cut my time shorter in my workout time, but I have it every day and I do it more days of the week rather than less days of the week? What are those kinds of things, the gives and takes that come with that? And so that we can begin to position how we're going to do those operations. I'm going to take a break, and when we come back, we'll talk a little bit about the strategies of positioning when you want to look at that growth. We're going to take a station break. We'll be right back.
Strategic Minds, Making Money Moves with Vicki Wright Hamilton focuses on helping entrepreneurs to overcome their business challenges to help increase their bottom line. Each episode provides strategies for growth and transformation. Watch Vicki share her 20-plus years of experience as a corporate executive to help entrepreneurs level up.
When we begin to think about our competition, we always want to run the other way. We say, oh no, I got to be better than, I have to beat them out, I have to do more. But I'd like to ask you to consider, think about competition in a little different way. All of your competitors are not great at everything. Just like in our own businesses, we all have some gap that could be filled. So I contend, let's find where our competitors could utilize our services to make a better package. You know what it does? It opens up doors for opportunities for you. Likewise, they may have something that they can offer to you to complete your package. Let's remember, all customers, whether it's an individual or a company, they want the total package with the total value. So why don't you be a part of that value? Welcome back. We're going to continue having our conversation about not only our portfolio of time, but also talking about how we want to expand our business. So now let's talk about the business side, the operations, right? You really want to, you said that you wanted to do more in the customer service realm because you really want to help people understand that there's value and that even Black businesses can have good customer service.
Yes.
Right? Yes. So, if that is the case, and we think about that service, have you thought about what kind of customer service are you looking at based upon the clients that you have today, mm-hmm. executive coaches and entrepreneurs? What kind of customer service do you want to do? Is it that you want to do phone calls? Is it that you want to do data entry? Is it, what kind of customer service are you looking to offer?
I think when it comes to clients, or their customers having issues with their products, with their services, that's what I want to focus on. So it may be like more of the general type of customer service realm where they're answering that question as soon as that phone call comes in and solving the problem, just being more problem solving and understanding. So maybe problem resolution or conflict resolution.
Oh, that's awesome. That's awesome. So if we want to look at conflict resolution or problem solving when someone calls in, that means that your customer reps have to be trained. They have to understand enough about the business or the product or the service or whatever that's being offered so that they can help to resolve some of those problems, you know, as they continue to move forward. It's going to be important that they do that. Now, that means that you have a couple of choices. You can't be the one doing customer service, right? So this opens up an opportunity for you to think about, so is there a firm out there I can partner with that already specializes in giving resources, you know, helping to do staff aug? Is there a firm I can use? Are there entrepreneurs out there that want to physically be doing the solving a problem? They want to physically be the ones that are answering questions for others. That's what their entrepreneurship is about, is their opportunities to partner where they can come in underneath you. You can partner in order to make that happen in terms of moving forward. So when you begin to think about your customer service, and then there's also about hiring people to work for you that are independent, right? Or employees, if you choose to have employees as opposed to 1099s or otherwise, you know, you can actually hire those customer service people. So if we decide that's the realm we want to go to, the question becomes, how do we get the word out? Well, we already have a pool of constituents already, the people you support, right? So you can upsell. Right? You're helping them do these things. You're the one that's helping them on the back end with all the things that are happening. Being able to offer them, look, if you're having challenges getting questions answered and clients served, I can help you with that, right? So that's the easy one. Those are the low-hanging fruit, the people you're already servicing. But now we have an opportunity to even expand it further. And the expansion comes in my ability to target my audience that I am looking for to serve in customer service in terms of moving forward, and these being the entrepreneurs and selling multiple packages. So you can have a package of I'm doing a virtual assistant, a package that, you know, in terms of the back office, a package that does customer service, a package. So you can offer multiple solutions as you're presenting your information out there as a business, right? So doing that means that your marketing efforts have to be targeted. Right? So do you have a marketing strategy today that you utilize?
Right now, it's been a lot of my references. I'm grateful because I've been doing such an awesome job. I'm able to have references that say, hey, this girl is great. Hire her. She'll help you out. So right now, my marketing strategy is just making sure that I'm, of course, doing an outstanding job and getting a lot of testimonials.
Okay. All right. So if you're getting testimonials, that's good to share, because when you package up, you can always share your testimonials that are there and your references that are there. That's awesome to be able to do that, because people want to know the caliber of person, you know, that they're going to be engaging with, especially when you're talking about a business of an entrepreneur. It's like that's their heart and soul, right? And they want to make sure that those pieces are in place. So that's good. But when I think about a strategy overall, it's about what platforms am I going to be on? So where do you market? It's about the consistency of my marketing. It's about the types of messages I want to market. And how am I going to say that message so it resonates with the person I want? So am I saying, are you looking for someone who can answer the phone for you and solve your problems? Are you looking for someone that is customer relationship oriented? Are you it's all about what are the characteristics that differentiate you? What makes you more value add than going to somebody else, right? And so your ability to tell the story and to be able to say the story of the savvy apprentice and what you're able to accomplish and the value that you can give them at the end of the day is going to be the best marketing you can have. Right?
Yes.
Because part of that story are your testimonials, are your referrals, and things that happen as well. I would encourage you to engage with audiences. Do audience engagement. There are entrepreneur associations out there. There are industry associations out there. There's all kinds of things that in terms of getting involvement, mm-hmm. engage with members. And become a member of some of them, right? So you can engage with other constituents that you can learn and hear what are some of the things that they're struggling with? What do they really need help with? What is it that I can solve to make their life easier? Because you know what it's all about, right?
That's what it's all about.
That's what it's all about. It's all about that customer service and that virtual assistant to help me and make it so that my problems are good to go, right, in terms of doing that. The other thing is that as you begin to expand into customer service, we all know that there's lots of components that differentiate our personalities, the way we answer the phone, our empathy. And, you know, we don't talk a lot about those kinds of skills. But empathy is important.
Very.
It's as you're dealing with individuals. But all of those soft skills that are there, and how are you going to determine who really has it, who doesn't? There might be an assessment that you want to offer to your people that are going to be doing this, so you're ensured that they have what it takes to be successful because they're riding on your brand.
Right. Exactly.
That's right. Yes. So they're riding on your brand. So you might think about doing assessments as you're interviewing these people, getting people in, understanding personalities, because every company, every person has their own culture and their own personality, their own brand, and what they want to do. So you want to make sure there's alignment there. So I would encourage you as you're continuing to do that, that you also begin to look at those components so that you know I'm giving the total package. You know, to my clients, and I'm able to offer them a total solution, and that I have already vetted enough to know how they're going to fit. So there are assessments out there that talk about cultural matches, right?
Right.
So being able to have customer service people that match the culture and the personality, that can be a competitive advantage, right? That, you know, understanding the environment, understanding how they work. Are they a fast company, a slow company? Do they make decisions fast? Are you allowed to make a lot of mistakes? Or are they a fail fast and it's okay to fail and let's just keep going? We just continue to learn from it. You know, are they innovative? Are they not? You know, there's all of these different decisions that we have to make as we move forward. We're going to take a station break. And when we come back, we'll also get a question or a tip or a comment from one of our audience members. We'll be right back.
Strategic Minds, Making Money Moves, with Vicki Wright Hamilton, focuses on helping entrepreneurs to overcome their business challenges to help increase their bottom line. Each episode provides strategies for growth and transformation. Watch Vicki share her 20-plus years of experience as a corporate executive to help entrepreneurs level up.
When we begin to think about our competition, we always want to run the other way. We say, oh no, I got to be better than, I have to beat them out, I have to do more. But I'd like to ask you to consider, think about competition in a little different way. All of your competitors are not great at everything. Just like in our own businesses, we all have some gap that could be filled. So I contend, let's find where our competitors could utilize our services to make a better package. You know what it does? It opens up doors for opportunities for you. Likewise, they may have something that they can offer to you to complete your package. Let's remember, all customers, whether it's an individual or a company, they want the total package with the total value. So why don't you be a part of that value? Welcome back. So as we were talking and looking about, thinking about the customer service realm, and we were talking about how do we continue to move forward, just remember that your engagement with individuals is really important. The ability to touch your potential customers, follow your potential customers. I mean, today we have more opportunity than we ever had before. You know, when I mean, social media, come on. You know, you can find what everybody's doing. You can do industry research. You can find articles that people have published, where they've spoken, where they have been recognized. There's nothing more complimentary than, you know, as an entrepreneur is out there slaving and slaving and slaving, is to have somebody come and say, I saw you in this article, right? Or I heard you speak at so-and-so, and this is what it said to me. You know, not asking for anything, but building that relationship, even though we have to do it virtually, you know, as we continue to move forward. So let's see if we have a question from our audience.
Hi, I'm Nishiki Chandler with Thrive Now Wellness. And it's great that you are offering or expanding to offer customer service solutions for entrepreneurs. And as an entrepreneur, I highly suggest and recommend that you expand that even further and offer some customer relations opportunities as well. So, for example, I would love to be able to send birthday cards or birthday emails to all of my former clients and current clients. I'd also like to be able to make sure that I send them holiday gifts and holiday emails. And so that keeps me top of mind, and it also keeps nurturing that relationship.
Right.
So I think you should consider that as well.
Oh, wow. I think I will. That's beautiful. I love it.
Yeah. So thank you so much for that. It's great to see this is what this is all about,
yes.
You know, getting ideas, you know, all the way from others. And as you see, we have entrepreneurs that are in the audience,
yes.
You know, that are here as well. So I know that as you're building, as she was talking about building these relationships, the more people hear you, the more people see you, the more people that know you begin to say, okay, you're looking for a virtual assistant. Let me tell you where you go, right?
Right.
This is how you do it. Don't be afraid of getting on podcasts, on getting on other shows, getting on having conversations with other types of business leaders, letting them know. You know, you'd be surprised that even people who are in corporate America, within their own circles, they know somebody who's an entrepreneur. They know somebody who is in a small business that's trying to grow and develop, which is your target audience, as you said,
right.
That you really want to help, that can spread your name. And then dropping your collateral wherever you can, right? The
right.
Leave behind,
yes.
Right? The things that people can see can also help, right? In terms of letting them know. It's interesting. I remember when I first got started, and people don't do business cards anymore physically, but they do digital,
right?
Where you can do a digital card.
Mm-hmm.
But on the back of my card, it had my picture, so that they would never forget my face. And then it also had bullets of some of the top niche things that I did, so they wouldn't forget what I did.
Mm-hmm.
Because people get business cards all the time.
Right.
So now that it's digitally, you can do all kinds of things. You can have a creative video on the back of yours. I mean, there's all kinds of things that you can do to be unique, creative, and stand out that allows you the ability to truly be able to connect with your potential audience in terms of moving forward. So, you know, Celine, you have what it takes.
You
know, you're they always say, if you want to get something done, give it to a busy person. And my gosh, you're one busy person, right? And
yes.
You have what it takes to be able to do this. Start with your time portfolio, analyze it, understand it, and then sit back and say, what do I want it to be? This is what it is. What do I really want it to be? And then as you're thinking about this customer service, build a plan. You know, think about, you know, how much time I want to spend a night, a week, developing my plan for this customer service. Everything from who I want to market to, where I want to go speak, who I want to talk to, how am I going to share this with my current clients, people that are in there that are already part of my customer base, how am I going to share that? And then you get exposed to their circle already because you work in the back office, right?
Right.
Well, there's nothing like having somebody that, you know, you're talking to this, their client has some, have them say something to your direct client, right?
Right.
Another
yes.
connection point. Mm-hmm. Nothing says that you can't build a relationship with them and connect with them directly. So don't leave any stone unturned, because the one thing that I will tell you, and you probably have heard this on other episodes, you are selling your brand all the time because you represent that brand wherever you go.
That's right.
So people will know you by your brand when you go out there. And so you want that brand to say your message, and you want to be able to communicate that as you're moving forward. So I think it's really, really important that you really think about where are the places I can go. You know, we've named a few today.
Yes.
Who are the people that, you know, that I never connected to that I could, that I'm in contact with all the time, you know, so I can leverage some of their networks, you know, and how am I really going to launch this so it's successful? Because sometimes we can do too much.
Yeah.
And when you do too much, then something suffers and you don't want any of your quality to suffer.
Right.
So it's really important to start with that portfolio of time, because the planning for a new service, as you know, doing the first one wasn't easy.
Right.
So planning for a second one means that you really have to think about the timing and the strategy and how you're going to execute it so you can maximize your time.
Okay. Thank you so much, Vicki. I so appreciate you. Thank you.
Oh, you are more than welcome. And thank you so much for coming on the show today. I am so excited to have you. And I want you to keep in touch and let me know how things go. And looking forward to seeing it just prosper all over, right?
Yes.
And see that customer service blow up. So it was a pleasure. We look forward to seeing you on our next episode of Strategic Minds Making Money Moves. See you then.